Welcome to Iron Strong. In this episode, I'll be explaining to you how we plan the loads and routes that your pipe will be taking during delivery, and how much pipe can fit in a truck like this one, and how we come up with that number. Hi, I'm Martin Rodriguez, and I'm the inside sales coordinator here at McWane, Ductile, Utah. The trucks behind me are being loaded with ductile iron pipe that's going to be delivered to the US and Canada. Each job site requires different sizes and classes, and each class and size has different weight. The magic number for weight on a truck to get shipped is 40,000 pounds. But getting to that number can be quite of a puzzle. Because some jobs use different classes and different pipe, we use a truck building tool to help us get to that number. So here's a look at the truck building tool. You have two ways that you could enter in pipe for calculating a truck weight. You can enter it by pieces, or you can enter it by footage. Both of these will come to the same number and same conclusion, and you have some guides here on your right and down here at the bottom. You can enter it by pieces of pipe with the size, joint, class, and lining, which will give you the number up here, and you can enter it by footage. And once you enter in that number, it'll tell you if you have a truck or if you don't. So if you have 89 pieces of 8-inch Titan joint in class 350 with single lining, you'd have a full truck. But if you had 70 pieces of the same, you'd be short by about 8,000 pounds. This tool gives us a breakdown of how many pipe can fit on one truck. But we also use these scales to measure exactly how much each truck weighs. These scales are large enough for a truck and a trailer, and they're also incredibly accurate. 480, that can't be right. The main weight factor is, of course, the pipe that's being delivered. But in order to make sure that we stay within the legal limit for a truckload's weight, we have to remember a few things that can add up. The trailer weight can vary because in some instances, trailers are made out of aluminum, and others are made out of steel. The steel ones are a lot heavier than the aluminums, but of course can carry less pipe. Accessories like gaskets and lube are also a contributing factor to the weight. Don't forget about the fuel. Trucks carry about 300 gallons of diesel, and that's about 700 pounds that's added to the load. The best way to ship pipe is with a full truckload, but not everyone can always use a full truckload. When this happens, you have a few options. Your first option is to order more pipe that can be held for stock for future job. Second option is to wait for us to find another truck that's going in your general direction and we can fill the truck completely. Or as a last resort, we can ship the truck with only what you need. And when this happens, you will need to pay what is referred to as a light load fee. It's also known as a freight charge. It's where we calculate the weight based on the pipe that you're missing and the cost to ship that truck to its destination, including fuel and any applicable tariffs. If you'd like to play around with the McWane Ductile truck building tool, ask your local sales rep or give us a call. Thanks for watching this episode of Iron Strong. Until next time, work hard, work smart, work safe.